Cigarettes and whiskey. I've got that here somewhere.
That's about it, I believe, I can come up with right now.
All right, well, we're still all right. I think it's still interesting that they're only 15.
Uh-huh.
take care of yourself.
Okay, you too.
Hang in there.
Okay.
My buddy John the Presbyterian.
Grace and peace to you, Brother Ludlow.
How are you, old Fred? Well, we've missed you.
Well, I've missed you too. I actually hadn't missed you that much because I listened to you fairly regularly, but... 16.
You got another one?
Java Jive.
That's hard to believe. Yeah, well, okay.
You remember that one?
Yeah, very well, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm putting that down.
Ah, yes. One time I drank so much tequila, I woke up with an accent. Oh, yes.
How's your lovely daughter?
She's lovely as ever.
And how old is that child now?
That child is 9 and a half.
9 and a half. I think about her all the time. We were talking to some friends of ours the other day who are going to be part of this baby express thing where you go to the hospital, get your baby, and come on home in a few minutes.
Yes.
And I told them about you calling me one day and telling me that you were a new daddy, and in less than 24 hours, I was in the radio studio holding that baby. A great day.
Pioneered the concept.
A great day. Mm-hmm. I don't guess anybody's done any talk radio in this town holding a baby since then. John, you have a great day, old friend.
I'll do it. You too.
Keep listening.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Ed on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Ed.
Hey.
How you doing, partner?
This is my first time to call you. I listen to you all the time and just never had the nerve to call.
Well, we're glad you made it.
I get a little bit nervous when I call.
Listen, you sound like you've been doing this for years.
I can't. I start talking. I can't talk plain when I get a little nervous.
You're doing fine, partner.
I thought of one that country singer used to have, that Tom T. Hall.
Yeah, what was that?
Something about the old something and watermelon.
Old dogs and children and watermelon wine.
Yeah.
Boy,
yeah.
How did Leon the computer miss that?
Yeah, I remember that was a good one. I used to like to hear that.
That's one of my absolute favorites. One of my absolute favorites.
Well, like I said, I don't talk too plain, but can...
Ed, you do fine, buddy. You call us often. We love it.
Okay.
Hang in there.
All right.
Bye-bye. We're going to talk to Asterix in Snellville.
Good morning.
Good morning. How you doing?
I'm doing fine, but don't you know that computers are the invention of the devil for anybody over 30 years old?
Yeah, I know that.
Well, I have a few that he missed.
Do you really?
Yeah.
I'm starting to lose my confidence.
Oh, no, don't ever do that.
In Leon, yeah.
In Leon, right.
Yeah, right.
How about a cup of coffee, a sandwich, and yeast?
That's right.
And let's have another cup of coffee.
Must be 1,000 coffee songs.
Oh, sure. And the maybe we should... champagne. Did you have that one?
No, I didn't.
And an old Jerry Lee Lewis song, Drinking Wine, Studio.
That's right.
And this is stretching a little bit. Cracklin' Rosie.
Oh, that's stretching a lot.
Well, how about Lawrence Welk's Bubbles in the Wine?
Is that the name of that song?
That's the name of that song.
We thought about Tiny Bubbles.
Well,
and
yeah.
Then rejected. That's one of my favorite songs.
But the Bubbles song, his theme song is Bubbles in the Wine.
Okay, I'm putting it down.
Uh-huh.
I'm putting it down.
I never told you how I got my name, did I?
No, but I was going to ask you.
Well, my husband says I always have to have the last word about everything.
Oh, see.
That makes sense.
So you came out to be Asterix.
That's right.
All right.
I hope you get a lot more songs.
Well, I don't see how there could be any more. Gary, do you think there could be any more of these songs?
I think that must be it.
I think we've pretty well gotten them, thanks to you.
Oh, I doubt it very seriously.
But we'll see.
Have a good day.
Take care of yourself.
Bye.
Bye-bye. I don't think there could be any more, but we'll keep looking in our search for excellence. Let's talk to David. David, how you doing?
I'm fine. Hello, how are you?
I'm doing good, buddy.
I think you missed one.
Surely not.
I think you have.
What was it?
Red, Red Wine. I think that was by Neil Diamond.
Okay, I'm going to put that down. That's two Neil Diamond songs back to back.
But that is a song. I'm not sure he's the one that sang it, but that is a song.
Well, he's good enough. If it's good enough for Neil Diamond, it's good enough for me.
Okay.
You drive carefully out there.
I'll do it.
What part of town are you in?
Just right down here at Peachtree and near the Civic Center.
Still raining?
Misting.
It's yeah.
Still kind of wet out here.
It's miserable. Take care, buddy.
Okay, thank
Bye-bye.
You. Bye.
Linda on AM 750 WSB. How you doing, Linda?
Fine, and you?
Good.
I'm unlike the other lady. I miss my kids.
Well, I think she misses them, just probably not as much as you do. That's going to vary from child to child.
How about if I got a house full?
Yeah.
Bubbles in My Beer.
I don't know that one.
That buddy guy that come up with the Western Swing out in Texas.
Oh, really?
The Doughboys from way back when.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about. I know.
Is that you're watching the Bubbles in My Beer?
Okay, I got that one.
Does Papa Top, does that classify?
No, Papa Top wouldn't do it.
Wouldn't do
Although
it.
We know that's referring to a can holding a beverage, obviously. But he wouldn't get it for that one.
Well, we'll just go with Bubbles in My Beer then.
You take care of your sweet self and I'll talk to you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. 872-0750. Let's see. I believe we got Annette here. Annette, how you doing?
Ludlow, how you doing?
I'm doing fine. How you doing?
I don't know how you miss this one. This one's got name of three beverages in the title.
Oh, really?
Haven't you ever heard of one bourbon, one scotch, and one beer?
Never have, no.
Oh, no.
Who was the artist on that?
George Thorogood.
All right. Okay.
That's a good one.
I've got that one down.
I got to apologize to you, Ludlow.
All right.
You didn't say a word to me Saturday night.
Was I with you Saturday night?
You were with me Saturday night, and you didn't say a word.
Where were we?
I was snuggled up in my recliner on Sunday. And I was reading through your and Diane's book.
Uh-huh.
And I was so embarrassed I didn't know what to do.
Why were you embarrassed?
Because I realized that you were eating Saturday night. You were eating brightly colored snap beans.
Oh, wait. Saturday night. Where were we Saturday night? The Wildwood?
Wildwood.
At the Wildwood, that's right. Are you my Wildwood lady then?
I am.
All right.
What am I going to do for you, Ludlow?
Well, what's that?
Every Tuesday I cook green beans and I cook them the way you like them. And from now on I'm going to put you some aside.
Yeah, see, I'm never there. I'm never there on Tuesday.
I know, but I'm going to put them aside. They'll save.
I know. Oh, Lord, I know they'll save. And that's would be a good place to start in my crusade.
They taste like fan belts. I was embarrassed.
Yeah. Well, you know what's the truth. I know you cook them that way because you're afraid some Northerners are going to come in there.
Well, there's a lot of Yankees in these parts.
I know, but they got no business changing the way we eat.
Well.
I love those folks, and they bring in green money, and that's fine. But you ought to cook those beans almost to death, almost black.
Well, I'm going to start saving you some aside. Do you like black-eyed peas?
Do I like black-eyed peas? Yeah. Yeah, y'all have country cooking on...
On Tuesday.
And you know, I'm never there on Tuesday.
I know.
Yeah. All right, well, listen, I'll see you this weekend, and I'm going to expect now.
I'm going to have them. I'm not going to get embarrassed again.
All right, you be sweet.
You're a good man for not mentioning it.
Well, that's... No, I'm used to it. See, there was a time in this great land of ours when only a Howard Johnson's restaurant fixed them like that. Raw.
Oh.
When you bite them, they go snap.
But now we're Hojos.
They're supposed to go swish. Squish when you bite them. They ain't supposed to go pop, snap, crack, pop. People got it all backwards, and they cook their meat. A lot of folks, you don't, but a lot of folks cook their meat so it goes squish. Meat should be almost burned. The meat should go crack, and the beans should go squish.
Well, I'm going to keep that in mind.
We've had a seminar, and you have a wonderful restaurant, and we eat there about... twice a month, three times a month, because we love it. And we'll see you there next weekend.
Okay, talk to you later.
All right, be sweet. Thank you for calling.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Wildwood Restaurant up in the heart of the North Georgia Mountains. And that lady does know how to cook. I had some of her fried chicken the other night. Made my eyes roll back in my head. It is, and I know more about fried chicken than anybody on earth. Anybody on earth, when this country finally gets around to making a fried chicken czar, going to be me. It is 9:27 and a half. At AM 750 WSB.
Enjoy more mirth and madness with Ludlow Porch on AM 750 WSB. The phone lines are open for you at 872-0750 or 1-800-WSB-TALK. Now, here's Ludlow Porch.
All right, welcome back, gang. It is 9:33 now at AM 750 WSB. Still at 38 degrees. And we're talking about my computer, Leon, and the fact that we have discovered with your help that since songwriting started, that's been over 20 years ago, since the first song was ever written, there's only been so far 25 songs ever written with a drink or a beverage in its title. Interesting, interesting. WSB Radio.
Ludlow?
Yes, sir.
Milton Crabapple.
Hello, Sheriff. How are you?
Well, I'm here doing fine, Ludlow. Kind of raining this morning.
It is a little rainy. Too wet to plow.
Just got in from the hospital.
From the hospital?
Yes, sir.
What are you doing there?
Well, Ludlow, you wouldn't believe all the excitement that's been going on this morning.
Oh, really? What happened?
Yes, sir. Well, there's a woman called up to jail this morning, Ludlow, and she was having a baby.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir. And her husband was out of town someplace. Couldn't nobody find him. Yes, sir.
What'd you do?
Need some help. Well, sir, I run down in my truck, Ludlow, me and dude, and loaded her up and took her to the hospital.
You put her in the front? Put her in the front of the truck?
Well, no, sir. They weren't room. We had to put her in the back.
I see.
But now, dude was taking care of her, checking her pulse and her hemoglobin and all that stuff. Why was he getting her to the hospital, Ludlow? But I tell you something. We had to leave her up there now.
Yeah?
But we took her into that place, yes, sir, and put her on one of them, give her to one of them nurses, and they put her on one of them gurneys, and and they put a sheet over and all, but Ludlow, they're having problems. That place is filled up.
Really?
Yes, sir. They had her out in the hallway.
Uh-huh.
She was moaning and groaning. We waited around a long time. I seen a doctor coming down the hall, and I grabbed him. I told him he best check her out on account of they'd forgot about her, Ludlow.
Yeah.
I told him to check her out, and he checked her and lifted them sheets up and checked her out and said, everything's all right. Well, he come back about every 5 minutes of checking on her, Ludlow.
Uh-huh.
I tell you something, she was doing some howling out in that hall. I could tell she was fixing to have that baby, and I finally got that rascal, and I said, let me tell you something. I said, if you're any kind of a doctor at all, you'd take her in the back where she'd have that baby.
Uh-huh.
Well, he said he weren't no doctor at all. He said he was just down at the hospital visiting his brother-in-law. Yes, sir. I'll tell you something.
Yeah?
I reckon she's done had that baby by now.
I would imagine so.
Yes, sir. We're going to call back and check on her.
Yeah, let me know, because she might name that child after you.
Well, it was excitement, I'll tell you.
And dude checked her hemoglobin, didn't he?
Yes, sir.
Well, that's exactly.
Ludlow?
Yeah?
Now, I believe you're wrong on these songs. On account of dude come up with a couple of them.
Did he really?
Yes, sir. Want me to tell you?
Yeah.
There's two of them by George Jones. One of them, White Lightning.
Yeah?
Yes, sir, and there's one called C.C. Waterback.
Okay, well, water's certainly a drink or a beverage, isn't it?
Well, I believe that C.C. Waterback is one of them brands of some kind of whiskey.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir.
Well, we can put...
And then my favorite one was by Chef Willie called Homebrew Sue.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right, I'm going to put that one down because
Chef... He said there's another one called Golden Grain Jane, but I ain't never heard of it before. He may be putting you on now. I wouldn't write that one down.
No, we won't write that one down.
Okay.
He's pulling our leg. We strive for complete accuracy here, as you
yes,
know.
Sir. Yeah. Well, I believe you've done about got all of them.
Well, I think this is probably it. That's about 29 now.
Yes, sir. If I was you, I'd start giving away $20 to anybody to come up with another.
Yes, sir. Did you hear Gary went into convulsions out there?
Yes, sir. Well, you want to get them all.
Well, we do want to get them all, yes. Yes, we do.
How's Gary's feet doing?
Is Gary's feet?
Did you hear that fungus?
What fungus?
There's something on his foot.
I don't know about that.
Yes, sir. Well, I don't know.
I'll ask you about it.
Well, I was just checking in with you, Ludlow.
Well, listen, tell us how you...
I'll let you know about that baby.
Do that now. And yes, I want you to tell me about the album. How's it going?
Well, it's going fine, Ludlow. I was up in Rome this week.
You don't mean
yes,
it?
Yes, sir. They had me on a talk show up in some big radio station in Rome. I sat in with this fella, a nice fella, Ludlow.
Well, good.
Stayed up there for about 3 hours.
Did you show up?
Lots of phone calls.
I wish I'd known that.
Told lots of stories. Had a good time.
I wish I'd have been there.
Well, there wasn't much room for you there, Ludlow. There weren't but two chairs in that place.
Well, I was...
It wasn't a nice big place like your studio.
Well, I would stand up to be in your presence.
Well, it was a nice place.
Well, I'm glad it's doing well.
Yes, sir. I believe I'm going to Columbus in a week.
You don't mean it.
Yes, sir.
Well, we're big in Columbus. We'll tell them all you're coming. Where are you going to be in Columbus?
Well, I don't know. They just said there's a radio station in Columbus that wanted me to come down. I told them I'd go.
All right. Well, that's wonderful.
Yes, sir.
Let us know so we can plug it.
Of course, White Columns is the only place I really like to go, Ludlow.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Well, we love it.
Folks want to listen to me, they're going to have to tune in to Ludlow Porch. Yes, sir.
Sheriff, you have a great day, and let us know about the baby
yeah,
now.
Well, I'll be talking at you.
I appreciate it.
Yes, sir.
Bye-bye. Sheriff Milton Crabapple, ain't he something? Let's talk to Ron. Ron, on the radio. How you doing, partner?
Pretty good. Good morning, Lud.
Good morning, buddy.
I have three. You might have missed, good buddy.
I don't see how that's possible, but let's see.
Well, Weed, Whites, and Wine, I think Linda Ronstadt did it, and a few other people.
Okay, yeah, we did miss that one.
Tequila Sunrise.
Didn't we get that? I think we got
that. Okay, you might have gotten that.
Yeah, I think we got that.
And there was another one, Whiskey Rock and Roll, that Lynyrd Skynyrd did a few years
ago.
Yeah,
we don't have that. I'm going to put that down. And that's it?
Well, that's about it.
Okay, well, there's still not many.
You're right.
You take care of yourself. We're glad you called, partner.
Have a good day. Good
talk buddy. To you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Joseph, how you doing, Joseph?
Good morning, buddy.
Good morning, buddy.
Fine, Thursday.
Thank you.
Warm red wine. Remember that old country song?
I had forgotten it, but I do remember it now.
Warm red wine.
All right.
I'm stretching it a little bit. Neil Diamond, Love on the Rocks.
Yeah, that is stretching a little bit.
Yeah, have a good one, buddy.
All right, pal, thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Don in DeKalb County. Hello, Don.
Good morning, Lindley.
How you doing, cousin?
Wonderful.
Good.
I wanted to nudge Leon in his ear.
Your Leon needs to be unplugged.
Is he getting unhappy with all this?
I don't know.
Well, Leon didn't mention an old song by Grandpa Jones, that good old Mountain Dew.
Oh, boy. And that's an absolute country western classic.
It's a real original.
Yeah, no question.
The other one, he may not remember, a fellow by the name of Eddie Cantor. And Eddie Cantor had a song, and I think it might have been his theme song. It was about his wife. And it used to be, Ida, Sweet as Apple Cider.
Yeah, his theme song was, or his closing theme was, I love to spend each Wednesday with you as friends to friend. I'm sorry, it's true. What a great talent, and we don't hear enough about him.
Isn't that the truth?
Yeah, we really don't.
Yeah, I grew up listening to him.
Oh, we all did.
Yeah. Enjoyed it.
All right, you take care of yourself. Talk to you soon.
Bye.
Bye-bye. 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK. Here he is, Big Canoe. Hello, my man.
And hello to you this morning.
You laying in close to home today, are you?
Oh, I'm going to try. Milton Crabapple brought up a memory of a short story. Can I tell it to you?
Sure, certainly.
It's clean.
Never occurred to me that you'd tell any other kind.
Not another kind.
Unless we were alone.
All right. This lady rushed into the hospital. She was about to give birth to a baby. She said, hurry, 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 and the nurse rushed her into the elevator. And the baby was born going up on the elevator. And when she came to, she says, I'm so embarrassed, I'm just going to die. And the doctor said, well, there's nothing really to be embarrassed about. Why, just last year, a lady screeched to a halt in a cab, ran across the lawn, fell down on the lawn, and the baby was born in front of the hospital on the lawn with the news people flashing their cameras. She said, I know, that was me.
A little trouble with timing.
I'm going to complete the list, I think.
Okay, this is the last one?
Last four or five.
Okay.
One of my favorite songs of all time, it goes way back, it's called Blue Champagne.
Okay, do you remember who that was by?
It was Glenn Gray.
Okay, and it's Casaloma Orchestra.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cigarettes and Whiskey and Wild Wild Women.
Yeah, we've got that one.
Oh, yeah,
that's on the list, yeah.
Old Buttermilk Sky.
Oh, a great one.
Yeah.
Great one, yeah.
How about Shine? That's a Johnny Mercer song.
Yeah, and I always, somehow, well, that was Frankie Lane's first big
hit. Frankie Lane did it too, yeah.
That made Frankie Lane a star.
And,
but it's not, I think probably. That's a stretch,
borderline.
Yeah.
Another borderline.
All right.
Will the Moon Shine for Me?
No, that's a stretch.
Drink to me only with thine eyes. Don't count, does it?
No.
Okay.
No.
Well, that's all of them.
You have a great day, my man. When have you seen the sun up there?
Well, it's about 3 weeks now.
Yeah, I know. I felt like a mole when I left
up there. But I can see the mountains this morning.
Yeah, I got a glimpse of them yesterday, but not for long. Just a glimpse.
Right.
Just a glimpse. All right, I'll see you this weekend sometime.
All right, it's going to get better.
Hang in there, partner.
Right.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
It is 9:42, sure as shooting.
Hi.
Got a sorry computer. Got great bumper music. 872-0750. And you heard my friend from Big Canoe give us the last of the songs ever written about a beverage. So let's talk to Yogi. Where you been, Yogi?
I've been sitting here looking out my window watching the Fords go by.
All right, well, we're glad to have you back on the air.
Thank you.
I was glad to hear the sheriff talking this morning about the lady having the baby, and I hope that her hemoglobin is all right.
I do, too. I was worried about that.
That's so cute. I don't know whether water enters into your drinking. It enters into mine.
Definitely. Cool water, yes. All day I faced the barren waste without the taste of it. Yeah.
But about 70 years ago, my mother used to play for me on an old wind-up Victrola. Wasn't old then. A beautiful song from Hawaii called Drowsy Waters.
Drowsy Waters.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I'm going to put that one down.
Okay.
That's a brand new one on me.
Enjoying your program. I wish you could hear it. It's a beautiful thing.
Well, I wish I could, too. Why don't you practice up and you can sing it next time you call you?
I can hardly talk, much less sing.
You be sweet. I'll talk to you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. David on the radio. Hello, David.
How you doing, buddy?
I'm wide open, buddy. You doing all right?
Doing just fine.
Good.
Get over this weather for the last few days.
It's been just real yucky.
Got two songs for you.
I can't believe that.
I can't either. First of all, did you buy Leon in Atlanta?
No, actually, I bought Leon in down in Ware County in a pine grove. Had a tarp over him when I...
He still should have known better. Coca-Cola Cowboy.
Oh, boy. Mel Tillis.
Mel Tillis song.
Okay.
And one other one that Sheriff Crabapple ought to know a little bit about. Redneck, White Sox, and Blue Ribbon Beer.
All right. Yeah.
Just thought we'd pass it along.
I'm glad you called, cousin. You take care of yourself.
You take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Mary, you're on AM 750.
Ah, Ludlow, bro.
You... Oh, Mary, hold on just 1 second. Let me see if I can't clear that up. This sounds impossible. Mary, you still there?
Yeah.
I'm afraid that killed you. How you doing?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine.
Listen to this. Roll out the barrel. We'll have a barrel of fun. Yeah, have you heard that one?
Yeah, that will. So that's Beer Barrel Polka. That's the first one on Leon's list.
Oh.
Leon knew about Beer Barrel Polka.
Oh, well, thanks a million.
You take care of your sweet
thanks
self.
Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Carl on AM 750 WSB. Howdy, Carl.
Hello.
How you doing, bud?
Doing fine.
Carl, you're calling from Hardwick, right?
Right.
Where's Hardwick?
Right outside of Milledgeville.
Okay.
Central Georgia.
All right. Well, I'm glad to have you with us. I've been through Hardwick, but I couldn't remember where it was and still not exactly sure where it was or what I was doing there.
A tear in my beer, Hank and Hank Jr.?
We've got to have that one. Yeah, because the tear won't qualify, but the beer certainly.
Right.
Won't. Yeah.
Well, that's it.
Got you down. Thank you, partner.
Okay, down.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
872-0750, and we're going to talk to Paula on AM 750. Hello, Paula.
Hi there.
How you doing, my friend?
Fine.
Good.
Did you get on your list the Days of Wine and Roses?
Yeah.
That's, oh, good.
That's
I didn't hear that.
Number 9 on Leon's list, yes.
Oh, okay. Well, thanks.
All right, you be sweet. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. 872-0750, I believe. Let's see here. Who is next? Clark is next. Clark, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hey, guy.
Hi, buddy. How you doing?
Pretty good. My list has shrunk by the moment here.
Yeah. We've got them all now, I think.
And I'm down to one, but I don't remember the name of it. I only remember one line.
It's going to be tough. Let's see if we can help you out.
You'll remember it because it was a big song. Something or other, Puppy Dogs and Elderberry Wine.
Old Dogs and Children and Watermelon Wine.
Oh, is that what it was?
That's the one I'm thinking about.
Well, okay.
We got that one down, but we're glad you called.
See you, buddy.
Come see us. Bye. Bye-bye. It is 9:49 now at AM 750 WSB. We're going to check in with our very own meteorologist, Kirk Mellish.
Looking at a windy, cool, and gray day, high in the 40s. Tonight's low around 38. Tomorrow, morning fog, then partly cloudy afternoon, high near 55, low around 39. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
What have you
Wine Spootie-Ootie.
Yeah.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
I didn't get it. A caller got it.
Okay, then.
You take care.
Thank you. You have a good day.
Bye, buddy.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Awesome Annie. Hello, Annie.
Hello. This is Awesome Annie.
How you doing, my love?
I'm fine. And you this morning?
Good. Thank you.
Good. I have one. I haven't heard all of your show, but do you have rye whiskey?
No. And that's a great Tex Ritter classic. How could I miss that?
Yes. I don't remember that far back, but wasn't it a Channing song during the Civil War in their marching?
I don't know. But the first memory I have of that is it was a big hit by Tex Ritter, the cowboy country western singer.
Uh-huh.
If the ocean were whiskey and I was a duck, I'd dive to the bottom and never come up. It's called it's whiskey, rye, yeah. Whiskey, rye, whiskey, I cry. If I don't
that's
get
it.
Rye whiskey, I surely shall die. Now,
I
that,
think
that
it's
may
an
be.
Oldie.
It may be from the Civil War. I just don't know.
Well, you've converted me from country music to your fun show.
All right.
But just for me, one favor.
Okay.
Once a week, play Rocky Top.
You sound like a homesick Tennessee lady.
Well, I love the Middle Tennessee. I'm native Georgian, just north of Atlanta, close to Crabapple. But I love Rocky Top.
You know, I was telling Dave Folk the other day, I'm very fortunate in that my travels take me to Tennessee several times a year. And I'm always, I always forget what a beautiful state that is till I get up there. It is a gorgeous state.
It is.
It really is.
It is. You, and when you get up there, the last of August, first of September, the celebration, Walking Horse Show.
Yeah.
It's great.
You be good. I'll talk to you soon.
Let me give you my quote.
Okay.
Take time to laugh. Laughter is the music of the soul.
Oh, I believe. What a great quote. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Myself.
All right, I'll do it.
Bye now.
Sarah incoming. Hello, Sarah.
Hello.
How you doing?
I waited all this time, and that lady got my song.
Did she?
I've waited all morning to tell you about rye whiskey. So stretch your point and use Singing in the Rain.
Oh.
Everybody's singing that now?
Yeah, well, they ought to be.
Okay.
You take care of yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Bye-bye. Bye. Little Turkey, hello there.
Hi, Ludlow.
How you doing?
I'm okay.
Good.
Has it been years since you've done this on music, or have I missed something?
No, I don't think I've done this one. I've done it about other things, but not about drinks. Yeah, it's been a couple of years. Yeah.
I thought it'd been a long time.
Yeah.
But it was you that got me started on this.
Oh, really?
I have made a collection of songs on all kinds of different subjects.
Have you?
And
interesting.
I wrote a letter to you once, and I said I'd like to come see you about this. I don't know how to put it all together, what to do with it. But
well,
it's amazing what I've got.
How many titles do you have altogether?
Probably over 4,000.
Wow.
I did it without a computer, and since then I've gotten one.
Uh-huh.
So that's the only way I know some idea of what I've got. I've only got part of them listed in there now.
There should be a way to make that...
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think for your son of Leon, you ought to pay something over $400.
I bought this from a guy... from a guy in a pine grove in Ware County, and he had a tarp over this thing. I had a lot of stuff out there. All of them had tarps over it.
Yeah, well.
And I could have bought...
Could have been worse if it hadn't had a tarp.
Yeah, I could have bought either this or a Henry J. automobile. So I just, I decided to go for this.
Well, listen, do you consider juice a beverage?
I consider juice a beverage. Depending on what kind of juice.
Well, it says here, plant a watermelon vine on my grave and let the juice soak through.
Watermelon juice is definitely a beverage.
Okay. Now, here's another one.
What an awful title.
Another one about as long. There's not enough whiskey in Tennessee to take the ugly out of you.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah?
I love that. That is very good. I got that one down.
Okay, now, what about Milkman Keep Those Bottles Quiet?
Well, no, Milkman is not a beverage.
Okay. Partly he is.
But I remember that song very
okay.
well.
Okay, you know, You're the Cream in My Coffee?
Very good.
And Pepsi Cola hits the spot?
Not on this show.
Well, it was, you know, in the old days.
We drink Coke here, or we do without.
Okay. And then, out of, was it Gigi, The Night They Invented Champagne?
Yeah, we got that one, yeah.
You have Moonlight Cocktail?
No. Another good one.
You have coffee in a cardboard cup?
No, I never heard of that. Who did that?
I don't know.
Okay.
It's on my list.
Well,
how about I Love Coffee, I Love Tea?
I love the Java Jive, and it
mm-hmm.
loves me. The name of that song is Java Jive.
And we've Java?
We have it, yeah.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Yeah, we're in good shape.
How about And Her Tears Flowed Like Wine?
We have that one.
Well, I heard you say something about tears and beer.
Maybe we don't have that one. I'm going to put that one down. I'd rather have it twice because I figure I get more on a trade-in from Leon if he's...
One more.
All right.
Kisses Sweeter Than Wine.
Yeah, we have that one.
Well, I missed it.
Yeah.
Well...
And, you know, that was a song by Jimmie Rodgers, and I want to ask everybody out there, whatever happened to Jimmie Rodgers? He was a big star, and he was in some kind of tussle with some muggers or something, and they beat him up pretty bad. And I never heard anything else about
it. I'm not the one to ask about that.
Yeah. But maybe somebody out there will come to our rescue.
Okay, keep them rolling.
You be good. I'll talk to you.
Bye-bye.
Anybody out there know whatever happened to Jimmy Rogers? The last time I saw him or heard anything about him was years ago when Joey Bishop had that nighttime talk show. It ran about 3 weeks. And he went to the hospital to visit Jimmy Rogers, where somebody had just beat him all over the head. And it was some kind of mystery about exactly what happened. But in any event, if you know what happened to Jimmy Rogers, I hope he's still working. Great, pure-sounding voice. I'm going to get out of here now and make room for all of the news from the AM 750 WSB News Center. And I feel gratified to know that we now have every song about a beverage ever written.
Six Iraqi helicopter pilots have defected to Saudi Arabia. We asked AM 750 WSB's Middle East expert, Dr. Ken Stein, what the catalyst might have been to prompt that defection.
He has no idea what the motivation might be. They may be people who have no family at all in Iraq, and they have nothing to lose. These may be individuals who, maybe over a long period of time, were spies. The conjecture runs anywhere from A to Z in your alphabet.
Stein says what's important is not the defections themselves, but the information the pilots might bring. AM 750 WSB monitors the crisis in the Gulf around the clock with updates every hour and half hour, and will break in with new developments as they happen. AM 750 WSB News Center time, 10:02. Just ahead, an update on that dairy recall in Atlanta, plus the weather from Atlanta's only full-time radio meteorologist.
This January, Callaway Gardens Resort has a package that'll make you feel like a kid again. You can go out and play. You'll love our games. Golf or tennis. If that's not good enough for you, you can always go to your room.
But hey, this is one time when going to your room isn't such a bad deal, you know? Because they're putting you in the cottages. And these cottages have like fireplaces and kitchens and some serious munchies, man. I mean, you wouldn't believe all the munchies. Then later,
you can go to the gardens where you can see like butterflies and really neat plants. If you're lucky, you'll see a snake or spiders. Cool! Be sure to bring your sister. And all for...
all for $48 per person, per night, based on double occupancy, minimum two-night stay. The Callaway Gardens Resort Winter Getaway. It'll make you feel like a kid again. But try to be mature about it. Visit Callaway Gardens Resort, 70 miles southwest of Atlanta. Or call 1-800-282-8181.
If you've ever even thought about owning a computer, I'm 10:04. Georgia's Commissioner of Agriculture gives Mathis Milk a clean bill of health. Tommy Irvin says tests of the milk products all meet federal standards. Last week, more than 40,000 gallons had to be recalled and destroyed because some Mathis cows ate some bad feed.
Some peanut meal, which is from some peanuts that could not go into the edible trade, was converted into feed, which probably should not have been done. And some distillery grain that had some pretty high levels of aflatoxin in it. So it came from two different sources.
Aflatoxin occurs naturally, but it is a cancer-causing toxin. The Bad Mathis milk products contain aflatoxin levels higher than the law allows. The recession is taking a toll on the federal budget deficit. The Washington Post says the administration is now projecting the 1991 deficit could rise to $325 billion. That's up from November's estimate of $300 billion. Pan Am Airlines has filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy, but it says flights will continue while it reorganizes its debts. The time, 10:05. WSB Skycopter. Skyplane traffic helps you save time this afternoon. Hear a report every 6 minutes only on AM 750 WSB. Now, Atlanta's most accurate weather with WSB meteorologist Kirk Mellish.
In Saudi Arabia today, high around 67, low around 37. My exclusive five-day forecast for Atlanta today, light rain at times, cool and windy, high 43 to 48, mainly cloudy tonight, low around 38.
You're tuned to AM 750 WSB, the home of entertaining and informative talk shows. The phone lines are open for you to talk with Ludlow Porch at 872-0750. That's 872-0750. Here's Ludlow Porch.
All right, 7 minutes after 10 o'clock. The time chill factor, of course, makes that 115. Wind chill. Dave Folk, are you still there?
Yeah.
You pick right up on this stuff from all the weather forecasters and all, aren't you?
Well, I'm looking right here.
What you're trying to do, and I ought to slap you right upside the head. If I wasn't afraid, you'd slap me back.
No, wait a minute. It feels cold out there, Luddy.
No, it feels like it's 38 with the wind blowing. 21 degrees. That's awful.
It was down to 16 at the Hartsfield Airport.
Uh-huh. You're trying to panic the populace. That's what you're trying to do.
No, it's just cold.
You liberal newscasters. Go back to work, Dave, folks. I'll talk to you, buddy. Bye-bye. What a nature's nobleman. And I mean that sincerely. 8 minutes after 10 o'clock, we're going to talk to Junebug on AM 750 WSB. Junebug, how you doing?
Well, hey, sweet thing.
Don't you think it's remarkable, Junebug, that we've been able to get all of the songs?
But you know what? I got one for you. And by the way, you scared me to death a while ago when you said 115. I got to get out of here before then. You scared me. I figured I got a few minutes. I'm going to listen to Ludlow.
Well, you think that's bad. The date factor makes this June, too.
I know it. Listen, I got the shortest one on record.
All
but
right.
It's one, I guess, that if you hear it, it'll make you might make you some money. Things go better with Coke.
Yeah, we decided
that's
not...
the shortest song ever written, but I wonder how much money it's made.
sold a lot of Coke.
Listen, you know, yesterday I was in the Capitol. I went down to Casa Joint over before it opens up next Monday.
You getting ready to get after them?
Yeah, man. We had 70 people we brought down there to teach them how to be advocates. And notice I said advocates, not lobbyists.
Okay.
And so old Buddy Childress was first one, so I plopped one on him, you know, and I looked down at him, and I said, hey, you got your name tag on upside down. So I was fixing to straighten it out, and he said, and I really did fix him. He says, and on top of that, he said, I got it on the wrong shoulder, wrong side. So I told him, I said, hey, it's too early yet in the session for you to be stressed out already.
Yeah, so you got...
That gives you an idea what we're going to be in for this time.
You're always down there, and while you're not a lobbyist, you're, I guess, an advocate for the.
I'm advocate for anything that needs advocate.
But primarily for our senior citizens.
Right. No, not all that. I'm looking out for the ones that are working on being a senior citizen, like you and your children and all that junk.
Well, I guess we're all working on that, I guess.
That's right. You know what? Who's your country music singer you're going to have as a guest? I miss that.
Bill Anderson. Yeah.
All right. I've been trying to find out who's going to be Zell's stars down there for the country music gala.
Well, that's one.
That's going to be there, do you?
That's one of the things we're going to tell you about. Bill Anderson is one of them.
Oh, good.
And they're just a long list.
Oh, really? Well, good.
List.
Well, they'll be worth my time.
And if you see Zell, I'm looking to become a big shot on the state patrol.
All right.
So
I'll tell you what. Why don't you meet me down at Capitol for the swearing in? And you know, that sort of got me. He doesn't have to be there for the swearing in for the House. You know, Monday morning.
Yeah.
I called up Max's office to find out. I said, How come they're going to have it on? They always have it the second Tuesday in January. But I said, how can swearing in be when the governor won't be inaugurated till 2:30? And he said, leave it to you to come up with something like that. So I called Tom's office, and they said, no, that he doesn't have to be, that the speaker will be the one to do that.
All right, listen.
So
you
learn something new.
You'll be listening next Monday at 11 o'clock. We'll give you all the details.
I'll do it. And Happy New Year.
Okay, my love. Take care of yourself.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. We're going to talk to Betty in Cassville. What do you say, young lady?
Hello, hello.
How's everything in beautiful Cassville?
Well, it's dark and dreary.
Dark and dreary, yeah.
Yes, sir. Well, on your songs, have you got that Colorado Kool-Aid by Johnny Paycheck?
No, I don't. I sure don't. Maybe they excluded one by artists who are in jail.
Uh-huh.
We got it down now, though.
Uh-huh. Well, I hear that George Jones is going to be down there.
I've heard the same thing. I'll let you know. I'm not sure.
That's my man.
I think that is, I think, I think that's an accomplished fact. I think he will be here, but I'm not sure.
Uh-huh.
I'll let you know.
Okie dokie, we love you.
You be good. Love you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Days of Wine and Noses by Carl Malden. Do you know that Carl Malden has enough nose for the McGuire sisters? Let's talk to Bolt Upright. Hello, Bolt.
Good morning, Luddy.
How you doing?
I think you should have bought the Henry J.
I don't think there's any question about it.
I've got a couple for you.
All right.
Has anybody hit Whiskey River?
No. By golly, it's one, another one of my favorites.
And there's one that's an instrumental only. It's called the Coffee Song.
Okay, we'll put that down. Who did that?
That's on a Jive Bunny album.
Okay.
And then old David Allen Coe has got a couple that I can't imagine you missed. Jack Daniels, If You Please.
Ooh, no. Don't have that.
And what was his? Tennessee Whiskey.
All right, we have them now. By golly. Well, we got them all. What do you think?
I tell you what, Leon has lost his memory, hasn't he?
Yeah, and I may go to work on Leon. I may adjust him with a hammer.
How about a sledgehammer?
I love it.
Okay, you
I love
good
it. Life. You take care of yourself. Uh-huh. Bye-bye. All right, I think it's, let's see, we got 10, 20, 30, 40. Only 49 songs ever written. That's amazing. And we have them all. I love it. Let's talk to Henry on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Henry.
Hello, Luddy.
How you doing, bud?
Doing good. How you doing?
Doing just right.
I heard somebody say this morning that your cabin has 18 rooms.
No. It's a little old bitty. They put on your leg. It's a little old bitty place.
Yeah, they don't. There ain't no such houses up in Yellowjay, are they?
No, no.
I got a Freimeyer type problem. I wonder if one of your millions of listeners could help me with.
Well, let's see. But let me tell you now, if they don't, Freimeyer's going to be my guest tomorrow. You can call him back.
Okay. I bought a pair of rather expensive shoes. And I promptly got them wet. I don't mean damp. I mean wet.
You mean you went duck hunting in them?
Right.
Yeah.
And I stuck them up on a shelf in the laundry room to dry out. And when I went back to get them, they were dry, but they stunk to high heaven.
Huh.
Got mildew or something in there.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I've talked to the shoe repair shop, and they told me to wash them with saddle soap. That didn't help a bit. So I just wonder if there's any way I can save these shoes. I hate to throw them out because, like I said, they were rather expensive.
Well, now, do they still fit all right? They didn't shrink up and crackle and all that stuff?
No, they fit fine, but they stink.
They just got this bad odor.
Right.
We'll find out.
Okay.
Somebody will know, and we'll get back to you on it.
I appreciate that.
All right, bud. Take care of yourself.
You,
bye-bye.
Bye.
I'm dying to find out about Jimmy Rogers, and Bill up in Calhoun says he knows all about Jimmy.
Hey, Lud.
Hey, buddy. How you doing?
This is Bill in Calhoun.
Yes, sir.
I got some straight dope on Jimmy Rogers.
All right.
And incidentally, I'm an ex-Marine also.
All right.
Volunteered in World War II. He is buried in Meriden, Mississippi. He had a small marker for years, and in the last few years, I understand his daughter put a large marker up there.
But
he died at the age of 36, and I believe it was from tuberculosis. TV.
Yeah, let me tell you, we're talking about two different Jimmy Rogers.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, you're talking about the singing break.
The legendary Jimmy Rogers.
Sure, you're talking about the big one.
Oh, you're talking about the current one?
I'm talking about, well, he's not too current now. I'm talking about the one who did Honeycomb. Remember that?
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
I'm sorry. I was just misunderstood.
No, that's all right. That's all right, because I should have explained myself better, because...
okay.
You're talking about the real Jimmy Rogers.
Yeah. I'd been to his grave.
Yeah.
I worked for Lockheed, and I worked down there quite a few times in Meridian, so we walked out to his grave several times.
All right, buddy, I'm glad.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. Glad you called. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. 872-0750, Rick in Woodstock. Hello, Rick.
Hey, what about tequila?
I got that one. That's number six on Leon's list.
Sorry to bother you.
You didn't bother me, buddy. I do this for a living. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye. Bother me nothing. I love it. Jeannie.
Hi.
How you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Good.
Listen, I got two more for you.
All right.
Maybe you might already have them. I was a little late getting in this morning, getting listening to you.
Let's see.
Sorry about that.
That's all right. Let's see.
What about rum and Coca-Cola?
I got that, yeah.
Have you?
Uh-huh.
What about White Lightning? I figured you did.
Yeah, got both of those.
Well, I'm sorry, I'm late.
No, no, no. Rum and Coca-Cola was number 5 on Leon's list.
Okay.
Of course, we can't put a whole lot of credit in Leon anymore.
Where in the world is Leon?
Leon's my computer.
Oh, okay. Okay, I thought you found some mannequin somewhere.
No, no, world's only singing computer.
The only singing computer.
That's right.
I'd like to see that.
You push one button on Leon, and he does Some Enchanted Evening from South Pacific.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How neat. Uh-huh. I wish I could see that.
And he does it like George Jones.
Oh, come on.
It's an awful thing to listen to.
Well, I tell you, the way high-tech is, you know, there's no telling what they'll come up with.
Don't say high-tech, somebody'll hold a parade.
Okay.
You be sweet.
You take care of yourself.
Glad you called.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
872-0750. 1-800-WSB-TALK.
Some enchanted evening.
AM 750. WSB. When you...
said the...
Oh, here's our own meteorologist, Kirk Mellish.
Okay, Ludlow, not quite as rainy and quite as foggy as it's been lately. Temperatures aren't going anywhere, though, today, and it's going to be windy, adding a chill factor. For tomorrow, morning fog, then partly cloudy afternoon, high around 53, low around 39. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish. And
95 Prime Rib Special every Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday night is such a good deal on a great meal, there's really no excuse for missing it. Therefore, we are proud to present instead a selection from the stereophonic recording Memorable Dialogue from the Silent Movies, Volume 2. As you enjoy these classic performances, may we remind you that Steak and Ale's $8.95 Prime Rib Special is the same classic prime rib we're famous for, complete with bountiful salad bar and steaming baked potato.
Hi, Luddy. How are you?
I'm doing good. And how about your precious little self?
Well, I'm doing just fine. Been enjoying your show this morning. Love music, and this has been a lot of fun.
Well, thank you.
I think I may have dug up number 50 for Leon.
All right,
I hope I haven't missed hearing it. Do you remember an old, old song called Old Buttermilk Sky?
Yeah, but we have that. That's great.
Got it.
A great Johnny Mercer song. Yeah.
Well, I missed getting that one. I thought I had number 50.
Well, listen, you can't compete with computers in this day and age.
All righty. Well, thanks anyway.
Talk to you soon.
All righty.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Larry with some BS, it says here. No, no, I guess that's Bell South.
I always wondered what a salesman with the initials of BS would be worth. I got maybe one here that Leon forgot.
All right, let's
Leon,
see.
And I can't believe that Leon would forget one that was done by somebody named Leon. Leon Russell did a song called Six Pack to Go.
Yeah, we have that.
You have that.
Yeah,
I had to get out and go to a meeting here a minute ago, so I may have missed a couple. One I had was an Emmy Lou Harris called One More Bottle of Wine.
Nope, I don't think we have that one.
That was written by Delbert McClinton.
Okay.
One More Bottle of Wine.
All right.
And, of course, these two, I'm sure you got. One is Scotch and Soda.
Yeah, that's number 2 on Leon's list.
Oh, yeah, he was smarter than I thought. Then.
Yeah.
And Coca-Cola Cowboy, I already heard somebody.
Yeah, got that one, yeah.
All right, well, he did well.
I'm going to go home tonight and oil him.
With what? Some of that tequila? Or,
I'll talk to you about that later.
Okay, good talking to you.
Okay, buddy, hang in there. Let's see. Billy, how you doing?
Hello, Lola.
How's it going, pal?
Oh, man, just right. Enjoy talking to you. Enjoy
good.
Yourself.
Thank you.
I got something for you.
All right.
First thing I'd like to say is, if you don't agree with me, some of what I say, you insult my intelligence.
All right.
And the other thing is, I got you a song. It's my favorite. I think it'll be as appropriate for today. And to start off with, it's too late for demonstrations. It's too late for debates. And all our senators and congressmen need to do is go to Washington, Senate Telegraph, and have it tuned to the song of Send the Word Over There.
Okay.
Send the word over. How'd that go?
Over there.
So But you know,
send the word to beware. That's the way that works.
Yeah, I think, and then he'll get the message, and everything will begin to happen in 12 hours.
You mean, who will get the message?
Iraq. That fellow there, you know,
yeah,
that ain't worth one of our boys' lives.
Are you saying that you don't think he takes us seriously?
No, but when he hears that song.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, send the word over there.
Okay.
But you're going to have to say rebels. We can't say Yankees because it's all Southerners.
What's all Southerners?
Most of our boys over there. Aren't they?
I don't, not to my knowledge.
21% of them anyway.
I don't know.
Well, anyway, I think we need, what's next? That song, I hadn't heard it lately. Hadn't heard it in a long time, but it was one of my favorites.
You talking about over there?
Yes.
Yeah, George M. Cohan's song, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, great song. Great song. Take care of yourself. Talk to you soon. Let's talk to Arlene in Stone Mountain. How are you, Arlene?
Fine. How are you, Ludlow?
I am good, my friend.
You're sounding good this morning.
Feel good today. Feel good.
I think I have a song for you.
All right.
It's called Two Glasses of Buttermilk.
Two Glasses. Yeah, that's new.
Yeah. It's by Jimmy Davis. It's a Christian song.
Okay. Two Glasses of Buttermilk is a Christian song?
Mm-hmm.
That's...
Yeah, it's about an old lady that this beggar comes to her door and she didn't have anything to eat, so she gave him two glasses of buttermilk. And a few years later, she had to go in hospital and she didn't have the money to pay her bill. And when she went in to talk to him and make arrangements to pay her bill, this man was there and he told her bill was all paid, that she had paid it with two glasses of buttermilk.
All right. I love it.
Yeah. I thought you wouldn't have that one.
You take care of yourself.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Kathy on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Kathy.
Hi.
How you doing?
I think I have a song for you.
All right.
Music, Martinis, and Memories.
Yeah, don't have that.
Jackie Gleason.
Don't have that.
His orchestra.
Okay. You know what? I remember that.
It's a wonderful.
Yeah, I remember that big band sound.
Mm-hmm.
I do remember that.
Yep.
All right, got it down. Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Have a good day.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Wendell on AM 750 WSB. What do you say, Wendell?
There's a song from Merle Haggard. I don't know the name of the song, but it says When Coke Was Still Cola.
Yeah, I don't know the name of the song either.
Joint Was Still a Place to Go.
Yeah.
I don't remember the title of the song.
I don't either. Maybe somebody will call us in. We'll add that to our list if they do.
Two short stories.
Okay.
Milton Crabapple calling in about to carry a lady to the hospital. This true story now. When my wife was going to the hospital having my son, she was in labor, and there was this lady come in from Dawsonville while my wife was in the emergency room, sort of holding herself, and said she was having a baby, and they carried her back to the emergency room. By the time my wife was in her room with our newborn son, this lady was already in the bed with her baby laying in the incubator there in the room, and so I sat up all night out there with my wife, and the next morning this lady got up putting what belongings she had in a brown paper bag, and I said, "Where are you going?" She said, "I've got 50,000 chickens to feed at home."
She had better things to do than that, didn't she?
One little line from The Mouths of Babes. I don't ever have a chance to call you when you're on that subject, but
right.
My son was 3 or 4 years old, and he was always wanting to pick up tools and stuff, and I'd say, "Go get the rake, we're going to rake leaves," or "Go get the shovel, we're going to shovel this dirt," or "Go get the hoe, we're going to hoe the garden." So it came Christmas time, and I said, "Go get the axe, and we'll go get the axe, and we'll go cut us down a tree." He said, "No, Dad, we can't cut it down, we got to axe it down."
He had that figured out.
Thank you, Ludlow.
All right, bud, take care. We're going to go down to lovely Edenton, Georgia. Hello, Helen.
Hello, how are you?
I hope you know how lucky you are to live in Edenton.
I am.
Great place.
And I very much enjoy listening to your program. I listen every morning.
Thank you.
But I wanted to tell you, I cannot remember the name of the people that played it, but I remember back when, well, I'm 66, and I can remember back when I was a young girl listening to this song about, "I want to go home."
Yeah, "Oh, Lord, I want to go home."
No.
Different one.
This one was, "I've had too much to drink."
Oh, yeah.
and Show Me the Way to Go Home.
That's the name of it, Show Me the Way to Go Home. Tired and I Want to Go to Bed. Had a little drink about
that's
an hour
right.
ago.
It's got that one.
Went right to my head. No, we don't have that. And
I
the reason
we. I don't know how old it is, but I know there were two men here in Georgia that had a band and they played it.
Yeah, that's been a big hit for a lot of folks. That's, yeah.
And they went up to Nashville with it.
Uh huh. All right, we appreciate it, and you take care of everybody in Edenton for us.
Well, just wanted to let you know that people down in Edenton, Georgia, listen to you.
Well, I love it. Take care of yourself.
All right.
Talk to you soon.
Take care and enjoy your show.
Thank you, my love.
Bye-bye.
It is 10:28. Our number, 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK.
When it comes...
And you can join the fun with Ludlow Porch on AM 750 WSB. Dial 872-0750. That's 872-0750. Here's Ludlow Porch.
That was Cool Water by the Sons of the Pioneers. Probably the most famous beverage song ever written, I guess. And we have some very special visitors with us today. Miss Dorothy Knox has some guests with her from Brazil, and we're glad to have you all here. We hope you enjoy yourselves and come back and see us real, real soon. Thank you for coming. It is 10:35, and we're going to talk to Dudley on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Dudley.
Good morning, Lolo.
How you doing, bud?
Fine. Dudley Gravette from Mississippi.
All right.
I call you occasionally.
Well, good to have you.
I'm intrigued with all these old songs. They take me back.
Yeah, indeed.
To Mississippi in the late 20s and early 30s.
Yes, sir.
That lady from Edenton stole my thunder. I was going to turn that Show Me the Way to Go Home, turn it in.
Yeah, that's...
We used to ride around and drink a beer or so and sing that thing.
Well, you know, that's almost everybody has done that song, drunk or sober.
Right. And the more drunk, the more they sing.
Yeah.
There's another one we used to sing. It was a medley. It starts out with How Dry I Am.
Oh, yeah.
How Dry I Am. Nobody seems to give a drink from the old oaken bucket. I have a bunch of oldies here if you got time.
Okay.
There's a hillbilly song. I don't know who sang it. It's been about 20 years ago. Cigarettes and Whiskey and Wild, Wild Women.
By Red Engel. We got that. I'm going to play that in a little while.
You got that? Okay.
Yes, sir. I'm gonna play that in a little while. I know you hadn't heard it in a long time. You'll enjoy it.
It's been a long time. I like it.
Yeah.
The Maine Stein song, Rudy Vary.
Oh, yeah. Great one.
Y'all got that one?
Great one, yeah.
Old Buttermere Sky, Hoagy Carmichael.
Got that one, uh-huh.
Okay. Cocktail for Two with Spike Jones.
Got that one.
Okay. That's Drink to Me Only With Thine Eyes is another oldie.
Oh, yeah. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
Great song.
Well, as I say, they take you back.
Dudley, we're glad you're here visiting with us.
No, I live here. I've been here 35 years. I left Mississippi in 1938.
Well, then you're a native.
Oh, yes.
You've been here longer than a lot of folks.
I still kind of claim Mississippi, but I'm a Georgia.
All right, buddy.
Georgia girl.
Good to talk to you.
Thank you, brother.
Take care of yourself. Bye. Bye-bye. 872-0750. Here she is, Kitty Litter. Hello, my friend.
Uh-huh.
How you?
Ludlow.
Oh, I'm sorry that I saw your name come. You were still talking to Gary.
Well, that's all right. I quit talking to him.
Well, I apologize. I knew the second I hit that button, I found him.
Well, I just want to tell you, Luddy, that you can rest assured that June Ellison is not going to show up at the Big Heart Awards banquet.
Really?
Yes, you know.
I'm crushed.
I wouldn't, but you know, she has a very strange quirk. She goes to these awards banquets, and when the person gets up to accept the award, she gets up and tells everybody that they wet their pants. So, anyhow, I wanted to set your...
I feel better about that, Kitty.
Yeah, I wanted to set your mind at ease, Bloodlust.
I do feel better.
You know, that's a terrible characteristic for a person.
It is.
And she acts so pleased about it, too, that, you know, that's kind of embarrassing.
It is kind of embarrassing, and she's a tattletale.
I know it. She's a real blabbermouth, and she used to be so sweet and cute and perky, and now she's just a blabbermouth.
What else is going on?
Oh, well, I just thought I would, the orders are dribbling in for the Big Heart Award banquet.
Oh, good.
And I just wanted to be sure everybody had a chance to be there.
All right, well,
and it's next month. Time is of the essence.
Time is really a fly. I cannot believe this, because when they first told me about this, it seemed like it was going to happen, you know, 100 years down the road. So.
Yeah, me too, Ludlow. But anyhow, everybody that wants to get in on it, 934-5373 is the number to call.
934-5373.
Right, 934-5373.
All right.
And I just want to say that if you can't, you know, get up a whole table yourself, that I am putting different folks together. I've got another table going. We've got room for about, I think, four more at that one. And this is all for a good cause put on by the North Georgia Civitans. And that's going to, you know, this is going to be a lot of fun, I think.
Oh, I think so.
Especially without June Ellison showing up.
It better be because, it better be fun because I'm going to spend a lot of time there and I want to laugh while I'm there.
Oh, absolutely. And we're going to have a good time. Guy Sharp's going to be the master of ceremonies and all that good stuff.
Be fun.
Well, anyhow, if anybody wants to go, tell them to give me a call and I will see that they do.
Okay.
Take care of yourself.
And the number is 934-5373.
You got it.
All right, my love. You take care of yourself.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. One and only Kitty Litter. 872-0750 is our number. And a reminder that if you have a Bell South Mobility phone in your car, you can call all of our talk shows free, 872-0750. And if you're a Bell South customer, that's a free call. All right, 1042 now at AM 750 WSB. Let's talk to Don in beautiful Marietta. Hello, Don.
Hey, Ludlow.
How you doing, buddy?
I've got one more left here. I had about 10 of them, and they've been used up here.
All right.
And I'm not 100% sure about this one, but I don't recall the title, but it was something like, I'm wondering where you are tonight. I'm wondering if you are all right. I'm wondering if you think of me in my misery, and there stands the glass. Filled up to the brim.
It's called There Stands the Glass.
That's the name.
Yeah.
Well, that go into your category.
No. Well, no, but when we do one about drinking utensils, that'll be right there.
Well,
yeah, that's a classic song. I think that's a Lefty Frizzell song, There Stands the Glass.
Well, it is. It could be. I thought it was Ferlin Husky or Fair and Young.
Well, I may be wrong, but you're right about the title, There Stands the Glass.
Well, you got the title. I couldn't remember it. But I thought, what else would you do with a glass?
Well, that's true. But then we could do Old Man Moe's Done Kick the Bucket.
Well, I go along with that, too.
All right, my friend.
Thank you.
Glad you called.
You bet.
Bye-bye. Bonnie on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Bonnie.
Hey, Ludlow.
Yes, sir.
I've got a song for you, but I got an answer for a question a man called in several weeks ago.
Okay.
About why there were so many cedar trees planted along a fence row. And I don't know whether you ever found that or not.
Yeah, we did.
You did. The farmers put them out there because you could fasten the fence to them.
Well, but the real answer is that the birds sit on that fence and drop the seeds, and that's the reason.
Well,
they...
Well, we set them out.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, I bet you nobody's ever heard a sucking sidle through a straw.
Oh, listen, we've already got it.
Oh, I can't believe nobody's old enough to remember.
Oh, listen, all my kids used to sing that when we were going on a trip, worry everybody to death.
Huh?
Yeah, all the kids used to sing that in the car when we were going on a trip.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Yeah.
Because I'm old as that. And I knew that when I was little.
Yeah.
Okay.
You be sweet. Good to talk to you.
All right.
Bye-bye. David on AM 750 WSB. Hello, David.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing, partner?
I'm doing fine.
Good.
I got a couple here I don't know if you've gotten yet.
Let's see.
How about an old Merle Haggard phone, Misery and Gin?
No, don't have that.
How about Whiskey Bent and Hell Bound?
No, don't have that.
One of my all-time favorites, Rednecks, White Sox, and Blue Ribbon Beer.
Yeah, we got that.
Okay, I didn't hear that.
Got that.
Can I ask you a quick question?
Sure, buddy.
What town does Woody Duck live in?
Watkinsville.
I'm sorry?
Watkinsville.
Okay, thanks.
Bye, buddy. Bye-bye. Let's go down to Peachtree City and talk to Kim. Kim, how you doing? Kim. Kim in Peachtree City. Kim, I know you're there. I can hear you breathing. All right. Kim, sorry about that, because you waited a long time. Waited 20 minutes. Let's see. Diane had some car info about Jimmy Rogers, but she's gone. I hope they didn't have a fiery crash. Maybe she'll call back. Let's talk to Tunes in Forsyth County. What do you say, Tunes?
Well, I'm calling from Forsyth, Georgia.
Forsyth, Georgia?
Monroe County.
All right, I got you.
Well, I just had two more by Jimmy Buffett.
All right.
Boat Drinks. Have you ever heard of that?
Yeah, well, I don't know whether that qualifies or not. I guess I'll use that one.
Okay.
All right.
And then he had another one. I don't know if it qualifies either. It's called Why Don't We Get Drunk and...
Yeah, no, that doesn't qualify. but it's touching lyrics.
Well, I know about, Margaritaville, but
yeah.
I knew you already had that.
All right. Take care.
All right, you too.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Now we're going to talk to Kim in Peachtree City. How you doing, Kim?
Pretty good. How are you?
Fine.
I'm calling about that the songs here, and I think I've got some. Not real sure.
All right, let's see.
How about Good Friends, Good Whiskey, and Good Lovin'?
Kim, hold on 1 second. I need to do this. Now then, we've got your line cleared up. That's a good one.
Okay.
I'm going to put that one down.
All right, and how about Drinking Champagne by George Strait?
No, don't have that.
The new one?
Okay.
And that just about does it. Can I say one thing, Lolo?
Sure.
Can I say hey to my granny?
Well, bless your heart, of course. Is she listening?
Yeah, she's at work. I told her I was fixing to be on, and she got all excited and was making her whole department's Georgia State Patrol listen.
Well, she's a hard lady to excite, too, so I'm tickled, eh? if they got everybody listening, you betcha. You can say, what's her name?
Her name's Cora Noble.
Now, don't you tell anybody that she's your grandmother.
Okay, I won't.
Because they don't know she's old enough to have a grandchild your age. They think she's about 19, because you know she looks good. You take care of yourself.
Okay.
Bye-bye. 872-0750. Always say something nice about the State Patrol. You never know when that'll come in handy. We're going to talk to RN. Is this a registered nurse, or is this your name?
That's my initial.
How you doing, Oprah?
Doing great. How you doing
I'm
today?
Doing fine.
I don't have a song for you, but I have a request for you.
All right.
Do you remember Mrs. Evelyn Purcell or Evelyn Showalter that taught you in the fourth grade, I believe?
I sure do.
Would you like to make her day?
How would I do that?
By giving her a call. Mrs. Showalter had to give up her home about 3-4 weeks ago, and she's now in Christian City. I'd be happy to give you her telephone number.
All right, let me let you put that on hold. I'm going to put you on hold to do that because I don't want anybody calling and bothering that lady. But
right.
But I would like to do that.
She would be thrilled to death to hear from you. She loves you. She talks about you quite frequently.
You know, her father, a very influential man in my life, Mr. B.D. Purcell.
Yes, he was.
Who was the principal.
I didn't know if you knew her by Purcell or by Showalter.
I knew her by both.
That's right.
The first time I ever knew her, she was a single lady, and then she got married. But that's All right, yeah, and she's a Christian city?
She's a Christian city. She's a lovely lady. She's a pillar of our church, and it didn't make her feel too good to have to give up her home, but she can't live alone any longer.
Certainly not.
And so she would be thrilled to death to hear from you, and I just thought maybe if I gave you a call, you'd be happy to do that.
I certainly would.
I don't know whether you'll do it over the radio or not.
I don't want to do it over the radio, but
she would be glad to hear from you.
I will call her.
Great. If you put me on hold, I'll give you her number.
Okay, I sure will. I'm going to put you on hold, and Gary will take this number. Interesting story. I wrote a story one time in a book about Mr. Purcell catching a bunch of us at what we called the wash hole, which was very close to Central Park School.
Yeah.
It was, and we were all buck naked.
How about that?
And the next day, well, he walked up on the bank, and somebody said, "Here comes Mr. Purcell," and away we went down that creek, grabbing up our clothes as we went. And all he could see was these little, we were fourth, fifth grade.
Yeah.
These little bear behinds going down that creek. And I, looking back on it, I know he must have fell on the ground laughing, but the next day at chapel, called everybody in there, and he said, "I know who you were, and I want you to confess. It'll go easier on you if you confess." And I sat there in my little fourth grade mind and said, "I'm going to gut this out." He didn't recognize my backside. And sure enough, he didn't. But I would have loved to have talked to him about that, because I know that he recognized all of us and must have died laughing about that. Oh, I'll put you on hold. Hang on now.
All right.
Okay. If you get that number for me, Gary, I would appreciate it. We're going to check in now with our own meteorologist, Kirk Mellish.
Looking at a windy, cool, and gray day, high in the 40s, tonight's low around 38, tomorrow morning fog, then partly cloudy afternoon, high near 55, low around 39. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
All right, 38 degrees, wind chill factor of 38. It is 10:52 at AM 750 WSB. We're going to talk to George out in Powder Springs. What do you say, George?
Hey, Lalo, how are you this morning?
I'm doing good, buddy.
I reckon I'm all right.
Good.
How about Under the Anheuser-Busch? That's a Budweiser song.
Yeah, but it's got to have a beverage in the title to qualify.
Oh, in the title?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I faux pas. If I think of another one, I'll call you back.
You didn't faux pas at all. We're delighted you called. Take
all
care
right.
of yourself.
Have a good one.
All right, buddy. Bye-bye. 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK. We're going to go down to Monroe and talk to Grandpa. Hello, Grandpa in Monroe.
Hello, Ludlow. How are you today?
I'm fine, and how's everything in Walton County?
It's rainy and gloomy and tiresome.
Well, it's going to get better by and by.
You make a bright spot in the day, though, with
your
humorous subject today.
Thank you.
But now, how about, and these are all old ones because I'm an old man, who threw the overalls in Mrs. Murphy's chowder?
Isn't it a kind of a stretch to call chowder a liquid?
I don't know. You can't have chowder without a liquid.
I guess you're right.
Well, then also, Shirley Temple's song, Animal Crackers in My Soup.
Okay. All right. Got that one now.
And
that's
now...
Good.
Les Brown and his band of renown at the Roosevelt Hotel in New Orleans used to play the Bourbon Street Blues.
Bourbon is certainly a
liquid.
A liquid, sure, a beverage.
Now, another Shirley Temple song was something about lemonade stands in the air, Cracker Jack bands fill the air, or something like that, everywhere. Lemonade stands everywhere.
Yeah. I remember that.
All right. Then how about, this is a very old one, back in the teens and 20s. It has to do with, it happened in Monterey. One line says, "Stars and steel guitars and luscious lips as red as wine."
Right. The name of that is, "It Happened in Old Monterey." Yeah.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, yeah.
And let's see, do I have another? No, someone else stole mine while I was waiting on you. I had three or four more, but they were all taken while I've been trying for a long time.
We are glad you got in, and you take care of yourself, and call us soon.
All right.
Okay, my friend.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Very special visitors with us today. We have got a crowd of young folks, fourth graders from Indian Creek School in Clarkston, and we are glad to have y'all. Hope you enjoy yourselves, and you come back and see us real soon. Stay inside as long as you can because it's raining out there. It is 10:55 now, and we're going to talk to Jeff. What do you say, Jeff?
Ludlow, did you catch the PBS show last night, The Last Train Across Canada?
No, I didn't. Somebody called me and told me about that, and I didn't get to it. And I ought to be. We went out to dinner with some friends, and I just didn't think about recording it.
I heard about it yesterday morning listening to the program and then watched it last night, and it was absolutely a wonderful two-hour program.
I just knew it would be. We went out last night, and I forgot to record it.
The reason I'm calling is, are you aware of any such train rides that folks can take with the passenger cars and what have you that are not Amtrak devastated?
You mean in Canada?
No, out of Atlanta.
No, well, there's that Georgia Railroad.
Uh-huh.
Maybe somebody will call and give us some kind of schedule on that. And every year when the leaves are in bloom, when the leaves are changing color,
mm-hmm.
There's an excursion goes to North Georgia. Maybe somebody call and get some information on that, because I'd love to have that for myself, too.
Is there some kind of central source, Ludlow, that someone can call to find out just what passenger trains are operating?
You might see if there's, well...
You know, Amtrak's ruined the game totally.
No question about that. No, Amtrak is the game now, unfortunately, except for special events like this Georgia Railroad and these trips to North Georgia to see the leaves.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe somebody will call in. We got a lot of railroad buffs out there. Maybe they'll call in and help us out.
Yeah, I didn't realize that you were a railroad buff.
Oh, listen, that's great fun. Great fun. Precious memories.
Oh, absolutely. My son's in the Navy in the submarine service and about to go back out for 3 months here in about 10 days, and he was up for Christmas, and we took out a HO set that I'd given him 20 years ago. And rebuilt it.
And you sat down on the floor like two children and watched it run, didn't you?
Oh, I tell you what, we were exactly like two children.
That's wonderful.
It was the most, probably the high spot of the whole holiday season.
That's
for both of
us. Great. That's great. Congratulations on that. You have retained a great amount of your youth, and you'll never be old, my friend.
You're absolutely right.
Good to talk to you.
Thanks, love.
All right, we'll find out something for you. Keep listening.
I'll do it.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, let's talk to Karen on AM 750 WSB. Hello there.
Hello, how you doing?
I'm doing great. How you doing?
I'm doing great.
Good.
I had two songs. I don't know if you have them or not already.
Let's see.
The first one is Gonna Hire a Wino.
Well, wino is not exactly a beverage.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but what a great song.
And the other one was Whiskey on Ice.
Don't have that. Don't have. Okay, got it now.
Okay, thanks.
You be sweet.
Enjoy
I'll talk
show.
To you. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. We're going to talk to Bubba Van Dyke in Sandy Springs. Hello, Bubba.
Hello, Ludlow. How are you?
I'm great. How you doing?
Good, good. You've only scratched the surface because you hadn't got into classical music.
I know it.
And J.S. Bach in 1734 wrote a whole cantata about coffee. Called the Coffee Cantata.
All right. Well, that certainly qualifies.
And then there are dozens, probably even hundreds of drinking songs from operas and operettas.
Yeah, those folks like to hold those mugs up in the air.
Right, champagne and all that kind of stuff, yeah.
Oh, a song by the fire.
One that comes to my mind is Jacovino from Don Giovanni.
All right, that's another one.
Probably dozens, probably hundreds of songs.
Yeah, we get into the classics, we're going to get into a bunch of them. There's no question about it.
Right, I'm also a fan of B.D. Purcell, by the way.
Are you really?
Yeah, I went to Central Park Elementary a couple of years before you did.
Yeah.
But he was a fine gentleman.
No question about that. I remember the first time I ever met him,
mm-hmm.
the first time I ever saw him, he was speaking through a megaphone to an auditorium full of rowdy children.
Yeah.
And I thought, that's the meanest man on the face of God's earth.
I remember those chapels, I tell you.
He was not a mean man. He was a loving, nice man.
He certainly was. He had a commanding presence.
No question about it, and was a very important factor in my life.
When he spoke, you paid attention.
Guarantee you, because I was convinced if you got sent to the office, they could kill you, and your mama couldn't even ask about it.
And you probably deserved it, too.
He was a very great man.
Certainly was.
Take
good
care.
To talk to you.
Good to talk to another alumni.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
Right.
We're going to get out of here and make room for all the news from the AM 750 WSB News Center, and then right back with some more two-way conversation. You anchor in and stand by, because, boy, we're having fun now.
depend on it.
A preachment, dear friends, you're about to receive on John Barleycorn, nicotine, and the temptations of Eve. Okay, that's it. It was so good. Oh, once I was happy and had a good wife. I had enough money to last me for life. I met with a gal and we went on a spree. She taught me to smoke and drink whiskey. Cigarette and whiskey and wild, wild food. And drive you crazy, they'll drive you insane. Cigarette and whiskey and wild, wild food. They'll drive you crazy, they'll drive you insane.
Hey, sing Temptation, will you? Please.
Cigarettes is a blot on the whole human race. A man is a monkey with one in his face. Here's my definition, believe me, dear brother. A fire on one end, a fool on the t'other.
Cigarettes and whiskey and wild, wild women.
Somebody get that bum out of here. Or rather repent or they'll write on your grave. Two women in whiskey, here lies a poor slave. Take warning, dear stranger, take warning, dear friend. They'll write in big letters these words at the end.
Cigarettes and whiskey and wild, wild women. They'll drive you crazy.
Hold it, brother. My friend, I'm afraid you're in the wrong place. We don't sing that kind of music here.
Okay. Then show us your muscles.
It's time for fun and interesting conversation with Ludlow Porch on AM 750 WSB. The lines are open for you at 872-0750. That's 872-0750. Here's Ludlow Porch.
All right, welcome back, gang. 10 minutes after 11 o'clock, still 38 degrees. Gadzooks, will it never warm up? Dave Folks says it's, you know, it's deathly cold out there, but I'm sticking with the 38-degree thing. Let's get right back to our phones and talk to my buddy, Quick Henry. Hello, old boy. How you doing?
Oh, I'm doing pretty good.
Good,
today.
Good.
Just became a new grandpapa.
Well, congratulations. That's wonderful.
The little creature's name is Erica. I presume it's a girl.
I hope so.
An incoherent call this morning.
A lot of giggling, laughing, crying going on.
Well, no, he's been up 24 hours. He didn't hardly know what was going on.
All right, well, congratulations to the whole family. Is this your first one?
Yeah.
Oh, that's great.
I got you a song.
Got me a song.
Maybe there, but I don't know.
Let's see.
99 bottles of beer on the wall.
Yeah.
Already got that.
Yeah.
What slime ball call that in?
Well, one of the very early slime balls call that in.
Well, shucks.
Well, that's not. Lose a few.
Yeah, I guess. Well, I just thought I'd give that a try.
Well, are you jumping on a plane to go somewhere and see this beautiful child?
We thought we would wait. She had a C-section. We thought we would wait a month or so and let her get home.
Yeah, that probably makes sense.
Get everything straightened out.
All right, where are they?
Before we decide, huh?
Where are they?
Out in Dallas.
Oh, that's...
easy to get there.
Good connections, yeah.
Hard to get out of the airport, but easy to get there.
Maybe the fog will be gone in a month.
Have you ever flown into DFW?
A long time ago, yeah. long time ago.
Man, that is a mess. It's not too hard to get out of, but it's a terror to get back into.
All right.
We'll see you later.
Hang in there, big guy. Congratulations. Sarah in Ackworth. Hi, Sarah.
Hey, it's the first time I've ever called you, but I guess I can't think of anything to say now, but I'll listen to you often.
Well, we appreciate it very much.
You live up in the mountains near Amicalola Falls, is that right?
Yes, ma'am. I live up there about 3.5 days a week, so that's
kind
of...
Are
you up there now? I'm back at the station today.
It's rainy, isn't it?
It really is.
I was up there in the fall, and it was beautiful. Have you ever been up there where that little church is, the High Shoals Church on the top of the falls up there?
No, I don't know how I missed it, because I've been all over up there. High Shoals Church.
Uh-huh. I went up there one day. We went up there to service.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it.
No, that's a new one on me.
Listen, these songs that you're playing, do they have to be about something to drink?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, mine's out there.
What was yours?
I was going to say that song, Don't Telephone, Don't Telegraph, Just Tell a Woman.
So you take care of yourself. Talk to you soon.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
The Sawdust Kid is on board. Hello, big and bad. How you doing?
Oh, and ugly, too.
Yeah, well, I wasn't going to say that.
Oh, break the glass, sound the alarm. You know who's here. Look, I had just bought, well, for Christmas, I got the Coupe de Gras, a cup of grass, whatever you want to call it, the top-notch number one computer. And it has the state-of-the-art drink finder capabilities. So I'm here to put it in
all this. We can wind this up, then move on.
We've covered both, this computer will cover both kinds of music.
Okay.
Country and Western. Okay? Got it all right here.
I got you.
Okay, now, this one's a stretch. So this one he threw out there just in case. Now we know this is probably a throwaway, so we'll throw it out there first.
All right.
Waterloo.
A stretch.
Yeah, okay. All right, now, High High's a Water Mama.
Good one.
Johnny Cash. Deep Water. I don't remember who that's by.
I don't either.
Surely somebody has suggested Little Brown Jug.
Little Brown Jug is a container.
Well, you keep what you want to in yours. I mean, Little Brown Jug. You ever seen anybody...
I wouldn't let them...
keep syrup in Little Brown Jug.
I wouldn't let them do There Stands the Glass, so I can't let them do... I can't let you do...
Okay.
Little Brown Jug.
Bloody Mary Morning.
Okay, yeah, there you go.
Down at the Corner Beer Joint.
All right.
Yesterday's Wine.
Okay.
That's it.
That's the last word?
Ain't no more.
Final end.
This computer, give you how state-of-the-art and everything. The computer's name is Bubba 2.
Bubba 2. I don't see how we could, possibly... find any more. Bubba 2 seemed like the
anybody
last one.
Anybody ain't got any more sense than to argue with somebody named Bubba don't need to be around no way.
Oh, listen, I know folks who would go down the road here and argue with the Darlington sign about the population. And folks will argue about anything.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Well, look, I enjoyed talking to old Garrow over there. Screened in?
Do what?
Screened in porch. Your fill-in man.
Oh, okay.
You didn't know that was his name?
No, I didn't know that.
Okay.
Certainly clever.
Well,
did you do...
Yeah, very original at it.
Did you do that while you were sober?
I can't remember.
All right, big boy.
Those days are few and far between.
I know that. I know that. You're bad to drink, as we say.
Yeah, and I'm bad at it, too, evidently.
You do it very well. I've seen you.
Oh, okay. Thank you very much.
All right, buddy. Take care of yourself.
Yeah. Bye.
And we have some special visitors with us today. Gary, I want you to look around. We are privileged to have the North Lake Tucker Welcome Wagon folks right here, and we are glad to have y'all. I have no idea what the Welcome Wagon... Y'all take the Welcome Wagon out when the new folks come into town, and they welcome your wagon. We are glad to have y'all with us, no matter what you do. Good-looking crowd. I thought it was Falcon cheerleaders when I first looked up. 872-0750. And Dave Folk outside trying to get one of these ladies to speak to him. And you know how he's doing that? He's wearing a scuba outfit. Our number, 872-0750. If you're outside our toll-free dialing area, it's 1-800-WSB-TALK.
Start your day with AM 750 WSB.
News, breaking local and national stories. Weather from our own meteorologist. Traffic, triple the coverage. Atlanta's morning news, weather, and traffic station, AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
Hi, this is Bobby Harper for OptiWorld, the one-hour eyewear and eye care superstores all over the Atlanta area who wish you a happy new year. And may 1991 be as great as 1990 was for you and the family. And the folks at OptiWorld would like to have you come in soon for your free spare pair. Let me explain. Come into OptiWorld and purchase a complete pair of eyeglasses or contact lenses, and then build your eyeglass wardrobe with a free spare pair. Now, the spare pair can be for reading, sports, a change of looks, or sunglasses. You simply choose your free pair from a special selection of frames with lenses prepared to your prescription, including bifocals, and this $100 value is absolutely free with the purchase of complete eyeglasses or contact lenses. Pretty good deal, huh? All you got to do is mention my name, Bobby Harper, or AM 750 WSB to take advantage of this outstanding offer. Mention me or the station you're listening to and get your free spare pair. And again, Happy New Year from all the folks at OptiWorld.
Hey there, this Paul Gonzalez. Want to invite you to join me tonight at 8 o'clock for Sound Off. One of our topics, the secrets of the Freemasons. So make sure you're here at 8 tonight. Now more of Ludlow on AM 750 WSB.
And here is our own meteorologist, Kirk Mellish.
Okay, Ludlow, not quite as rainy and quite as foggy as it's been lately. Temperatures aren't going anywhere, though, today, and it's going to be windy, adding a chill factor. For tomorrow, morning fog, then partly cloudy afternoon, high around 53, low around 39. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
All right. 19 minutes after 11 o'clock at 8720750. Let's talk to my buddy Kyle. Kyle, how you doing?
Pretty good. How are you doing, my bro?
Fine, buddy. Doing fine.
Yeah, I'm a first-time caller. Me and my father listen to you all the time.
Well, great. Thank you.
Okay, I have a question for you.
All right.
Do you know what branch of service Dan Quayle was in? Was it the Coast Guard or was it...
Army National Guard.
It was the Army National... Don't tell me that. I just lost $20.
I'm sorry. Would you like for me to lie about it? Because I will on a heartbeat for 20% of that $10.
At $20.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Please lie. It's my mother.
You can't lie to your mama.
For $20, I'd lie to anyone.
God will get you for lying to your mama for nothing, let alone for gain and profit. What did she say? She said
it was the Army National Guard. But I promise it's the Coast Guard.
No.
Oh God.
Sorry about that.
How's your Jeep doing?
Doing fine. Coming right along.
I got a Jeep, too, and I bought mine from Jasper, and I cannot stand it. It won't run. It's got more transmission problems. I know what to do with it.
Well, I wish you had mine, because it is a good one.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
All right, buddy, take care of yourself.
Okay, bye-bye.
Jim Clip.
How in the hell are you doing?
I'm doing fine, Jim. It seemed like I hadn't talked to you in 6 months. You've been behaving yourself.
It has been a while.
It's been entirely too long.
Yeah, I've been... Hey,
you've been out being a captain of industry?
No, not really. I've been sitting home getting waited on.
Oh, well, that's good. Getting waited on.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
You know, just laid back, eating those ham and eggs, well, drinking that good liquor.
Nobody deserves it any more than you.
I had a list of about 25 songs. All of them have been named. But...
I think we have them all now, Jim.
Yeah, I thought maybe a couple of old hillbilly songs that Sawdust Kid missed. They're Wading in Muddy Water. You got that one?
No, I'm putting that down right now.
And Applejack by Dolly.
All right.
And a couple that Lardo Dupree should have written.
Because Lardo might be working on them.
Yeah. These are songs that should be. And, of course, I pass the title on Lardo. You are the egg in my beer. And talking trash and drinking mash.
I love it. Incidentally, our beloved Freckles just called and said, and rightly so, that it was Webb Pierce that did There Stands the Glass, and she's exactly right.
Yeah, that's about 35 years old.
I didn't know how old it was, but I do remember that it was indeed Webb Pierce.
He done a bunch of them about 35 years ago. In fact, that's when he was popular with everybody except Lewis. It's popular Lewis now.
Lewis has lost a step or two the last few years.
3.5 decades.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, like I say, I hadn't talked to you in a while. But I was sorry I didn't get down to that book signing by Bo Whaley. You said he was going to give out personalized autographs.
Yeah.
And I'm just sick and tired of getting these impersonal autographs.
Well, now listen, see, because you made a fool of yourself, Jim. What I said was he's going to personalize the books, and he would have said to Jim Clip, "Why are you bothering me, Bo Whaley?"
Is that what he said?
And that makes it personalized. If he just signs Bo Whaley, then you got a signature.
Anyway, it wouldn't be personal if he just signed Bo Whaley.
That's right. That's right.
Just, you know, just want to clear that up.
If he says something like, "Get out of my face," then that's still not personalized.
That would make him your first cousin.
But he'll be back. He'll be back signing books again.
Yeah, I do want to get one of those personalized autographs.
Well, you'll like it. You'll like it.
I think I'd like to read his book. Nobody gave him one of his books.
Well, of course you would. Go buy you one. It's called...